it's a really bad idea to allow bad data to propagate across your pipeline. To prevent this, we have data expectations that allow you to assert that your inputs are within the parameters that you expect, and they also allow you to assert your output is correct. If your inputs are incorrect, your build won't even run. The data will get stale, but it's better for it to get stale than to have bad data that will then propagate to another team or another group doing machine learning on top of your data, using it for training, which then can generate a classifier that's going to be used in another group trying to do marketing or fraud detection. So let's assert our data both at the input and at the output so that we can make sure that we know what's being propagated and avoid corrupting the pipeline. The longer bad data goes undetected, the worse it is. So doing this as a day-to-day practice is a great idea. Let me show you how it gets done. We're again in the Foundry reference project. This time, we're going to add data expectations to the UI layer, or at least to the pipeline that backs it, which is the ontology project aviation. Let's start with flights. Opening flights, we see that there's already data expectations passing. Let's go and check what data expectations have already been added. We can see that there is one data expectation checking if the primary key is unique. We can see the primary key is generated. Opening the description shows us that the generation is based out of a columns. Let's test something more meaningful. For example, departure versus arrival of a flight. Here we can see that we have both columns for departure and arrival. The expectation would be that the arrival always happens after the departure. So if this doesn't happen, it's a data problem. Let's add a data expectation for it. We start by creating a new branch, because again, master is locked and good practices tell us that we should not push code directly into master. So the new branch we call add data expectations. Here we already have one check with all the imports done already. So let's just add another one. We can say check for the column departure, and we can then search through the autocomplete for the type of check that you want to add. In this case, we want the is before another column. Selecting it, we can say that departure is before the arrival, and we name this check departure should be before arrival. We tie these things up and run the check in preview mode. Preview only snapshots 1000 rows. So the check failed. From the 1000 rows, 391 have failed the check. The preview gives us a quick example of where this check has failed. For example, this arrival is almost 1 day before the departure. This is wrong, represents a data problem. We're not going to investigate the data problems here, but it's good to know that they exist. We can then go back and fix it. Running a full build shows us how many total rows actually failed against this check. After the build completes, the build itself fails because the check has not passed. This prevents bad data from propagating, and it gives us a quick example of where the check passed. It also tells us that from the 4 million rows this dataset has, almost 200,000 failed the check. This, again, does represent a data problem. It's up to the developer to say if they want a build to fail or for it to just get a warning. In this case, we're failing. You can see the failure both in data health and in the reasons why the build failed itself. Going back to the code, let's add another check. This time, let's check for the origin airport. And instead of checking at the dataset we're working in, let's check the input, which also has the same column, airport. Just for an example, we're going to check if the airport code is 3 characters at the input. We add a new check, where we verify if the column origin, which is airport origin, has exactly size of 3 characters. We also name this origin airport code should have 3 characters. And instead of failing the build, we're just going to ask it to warn us if it's wrong. Running the build, actually shows us that our test has failed. And the reason why it has failed is because size doesn't work against strings. It only works against arrays or maps. But I still want to test if the airport code has 3 characters. So let me go through the autocomplete and see if there's any other type of assertion that I could use instead of the size, which is reserved for arrays and maps. So going through a quick scroll, I can see that there is actually something that looks like a regex. So R like is a regex. Let's use that because then we can just verify if it does have 3 characters. We add a regex in place for checking if it has 3 consecutive characters. We hit preview and our data expectation will now pass. With this, we have now added data expectations at both input and output for this dataset. Thank you for listening and goodbye.